What's going on, everybody? It is that time of the week where we get to see the new episode of Bleach's previews, images, and synopsis. So we'll be breaking it down, giving just my opinions and thoughts about where we're going to be in the manga, and of course, what we're going to be expecting in the anime. Of course, with a brief synopsis, with bad translations, of course, and anything really in between and my predictions about things. So, if you like these type of videos, click that like, subscribe, and of course, let's get into it, shall we? So with episode 16, let's get straight into the synopsis. Kang Du, who appears before Baz B, approaches Hitsugaya with his Bankai Daigarin Hyorimaru in order to finish him off. Other soldiers were also forced to outnumber the enemy's attacks in various places. Around that time, Mayuri from the Technology Development Bureau received a call from Urahara, as we saw from last episode. Based on the information he had obtained from his battle with Kurge, Urahara was looking for a way to recover the Bankai, to which had been stolen. The Gotei 13 then called to each captain and vice captain and also reached to Amida Soifan, who was also confronting BG9. Again, translations are a bit stiff, but there you go. Now, of course, with any preview that we get from the website itself, we are going to get roughly about the first 10 minutes to 15 minutes of the episode, the first half, rather than the second half, and we'll discuss about the second half shortly. But to say that, most of my expectations for the first 5 to 10 minutes of the episode are going to be dialogue, getting an explanation about the retrieving of the Bankai, then the captains getting said pill to retrieve their Bankai, and then stuff happening. Now, of course, with Soifan, I do believe it is going to be fairly quick, considering on how damaged she is. Now, granted, I do believe that Soifan was probably in a better position than Toshiro, but considering that BG9 was, you know, playing with her after, you know, she was downed, maybe Toshiro is in fact in better health than her, and that's not saying much. In that regard, in the manga, Soifan doesn't really do much after she obtained her Bankai again, making one big explosion and, of course, kind of ending the conclusion to that fight fairly quickly. However, Toshiro, on the other hand, does have a fairly decent throwabout with Kang Du, and this is where I think a lot of the high animation fights might be happening within this episode and probably ones to look out for, because the second half, then we get onto Shinji, Bambietta, and Sergeant Komamura. Now, considering we know the episode title of episode 17, which I will do a video on at some point this week as well, we know that the title for that episode is going to be Heart of Wolf. So taking that into consideration, we know that Komamura's fight isn't going to be in this episode. However, it's definitely going to be setting up towards it. Something else that I find interesting within this preview on the website as well is that we get to see Shinji. Now, of course, this is where I feel things are going to start changing. Things from the manga are going to start deviating and probably going to get into that Shinji's Bankai. Whether it's going to be this episode or is it going to be next episode or the episode after that, we have like a 3-episode margin. If I had to say was this episode, which I'm not too confident about per se, I would say that this is him using his Bankai against a bunch of soldiers, which was mentioned within the synopsis of this preview, as we just mentioned, that he uses it against all those soldiers and then Bambietta comes in and then starts blowing stuff up. I do, however, feel that maybe this isn't the case, and this is basing my opinion off the PV that we got with Momo and Iba also being in the trailer, looking like they're actually doing something. So maybe I'm not so much convinced that Shinji's Bankai will be used in this episode, especially as I think everybody knows and the staff know that it will be kind of a monumental thing. So I feel that maybe this is going to be something in between the Komamura fight or slightly afterwards, and then maybe Baz B will then show up and, you know, start attacking Shinji after that fact. But regardless of what, from what I've seen of this episode, which is pertaining mainly Soifan stuff, is that it's going to look gorgeous in terms of Soifan, right? These images, again, just show that these are going to be kept on model. And again, just like with last episode, I appreciate the art. Every frame that you could pause on looked like an art piece that you could put on your wall. And I'm getting the same vibes from looking at these images as well. You have things such as Toshiro being damaged, and this is probably the point where he gets his Bankai back. The point of where Amida's giving her the pill, maybe, or where she's, you know, needs support for a Bankai. Urahara with his smug smile that is, you know, achieve something. And then, of course, Kang Du's appearance as well, which is probably going to be at the very start of the episode. So I do feel that from episode 1 all the way to 2 to 3 of this core, I do feel like each episode is getting slightly better and better and better. And the reason why I say this as well is because one of the episode directors of this is going to be an episode director of Gintama. And for those Gintama fans out there, you know that obviously Gintama, when it gets action-y, it's really good. But from my experience with Gintama, I've seen the first movie and the second movie, and I will say I really loved the second movie, and if he was the storyboarder behind the second movie, to which it seems he was, then I do believe that we might be in for a treat this episode. And I'm excited because I don't think he's been on a Bleach project yet. And the same with the key animators as well. So I'm very excited that we're going to get some new staff with this as well. And I guess that's the fun part, right? Because we don't really know what to expect and what this kind of episode is going to be like. And I think that's kind of exciting. So as a manga reader, I'm extremely excited for this episode because I feel like this is now the turning point of where things are going to start deviating, as I said. Are we going to see Momo and Iba actually do something? Like, please. I know Momo's done things in the Bleach series before, but Iba? Iba's done nothing. So I'm really excited to see what Iba has in store for us. And I'm pretty sure they show up before the Komamura fight. So I'm really sure that it's probably going to be this episode that hopefully Iba finally does something. And hey, I'll take some Momo as well. So I'm very, yeah, excited to see where this goes as a manga reader, because this is potentially going to be new stuff for me. And I'm very excited to see the next episode after this one as well, because, you know, people don't like CG. So, you know, it's going to be a very questionable episode, to say the least, until we see it. So a lot of anticipation in these next two upcoming episodes. So, I mean, with that being said, tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below of what you think of this episode. What do you think the deviation is going to be? Do you think Shinji is going to be using his Bankai within this episode? And what do you think of Momo and Iba? Do you hope that they actually do something? And yeah, with that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this one. I'm Debian Hansen. And as always, people, peace out.